suffer in silence and in poverty, and we know they was right. So what I'm saying to you is, Madea, make Tyler's ass step his ass up. I'm talking to Madea right now. Madea, I need you to pull Tyler's ass in the back and say, baby, you watching this sister and you watching her family starve.
All right.
What's up, YouTube? It is your boy once again with another episode of Foolery. So let's dig down into my black people bag and see what we can find today. Monique. Why is she? Well, who knows? So let's talk about one. She talked about several people on the club, Shay Shay. Everybody knows she went on there. They just released the videos like yesterday or the day before. Why she just won't let it go and move on? So she recently released the audio of her and Tyler Perry conversation. And listening to the audio, I think some things could have been settled out, but that husband of hers, I think that's the issue. I think that's the issue with everything going on with her right now. So we're not giving away too much. I'm going to let you guys check it out. Make sure y'all comment. Let me know what y'all think about it. I'll chime in here and there, but it's a lot if we pay attention. I'll jump in so we can recap. Let's do that. And make sure you guys caught up on what's going on. So, but before we do it, y'all know what to do. Hit that subscribe and that notification right now. To do what? To get the next video. So, no further ado, let's get it. Monique and, Daddy. The infamous audio recording.
We good? Because you've not answered that question. That's a very simple question.
I said to you earlier, that wouldn't be fair. I wouldn't think that was fair.
But what would you want to be done, sir?
How would you want it fixed, Tyler?
How would you want that fixed?
And
how would I want it fixed?
Let me tell you. So that, because, and my husband is that part of our team that he has the business conversations. I'm the part of the team that you saw May 13th on the stage. So what I would ask you is, because you're talking in Tyler Perry language, I would ask you to let Monique talk to Madea. Because when you start talking in Tyler Perry language, brother, you talk like you don't get it. Right, nigga. Right. You got to laugh at it because you know. Because you know. See, let me tell you. Let me tell you, Tyler. When I watch your movies, I dig Madea. And you know why I dig her? You know why I dig her, Tyler?
Because she could be your mother.
You know why I dig her?
Yeah.
You know why I dig her? Because that bitch is real to her gut. And she don't give a fuck how I come out. She don't give a fuck how it's taken. But everybody knows she love you, but she gonna tell you the real shit. See, when you stepped away from Madea and you became Tyler Perry, the billionaire, this is the conversation you're having. Like, well, guys, what do you want me to do? What do you want me to say? See, you a brother that slept in your car. And you needed niggas to fight for you to get you up out the goddamn car. See, your mama that you love so dearly. See, this is when I know that the powers that be and everybody saying on the radio and everybody saying on the media, oh, my God, it's Oprah and Tyler. They're the ones that can employ her. Why ever would she say it? Because I love them niggas. That's why I'm saying it. Because I'm tired of reading the stories 100 years from now where we had to go through this shit and we watch our brothers and sisters die and suffer in silence and in poverty. And we know they was right. So what I'm saying to you is, Madea, make Tyler's ass step his ass up. I'm talking to Madea right now. Madea, I need you to pull Tyler's ass in the back and say, baby, you watching this sister and you watching her family starve.
Okay, let's jump right in real quick. I think if I'm calling you to have a conversation and y'all coming at me like really chopping hard. A lot of, you know, vulgar language, profanity. You know, I would take a little offense too. I was like, okay, so I called trying to do this, but y'all keep coming to this. You know, y'all keep coming like a storm when I'm trying to stay calm about this. And you're trying to make your points, but y'all, you know what I'm saying? You beating it. You're not going to get no reaction out of nobody from that. Nobody's going to come out of that because, first of all, this man, y'all got to understand, Tyler went through them bumps. Tyler, he'll tell you, you know, he was broke, paying people, all kind of stuff. Living in the car, he did all that. But he learned somewhere in between there, I got to play this damn game. And that's what he did to get what he want. But now he's on top. How he going to play it? I don't know. But I don't think he's going to change for Monique. That's what I do know. Let's go.
You're watching it. And you're saying, what do you want me to do? Listen, don't you play with that baby like that. You know the shit y'all did was wrong to her. You gave charity, you gave them $400,000 to $500,000 to charity, and you know that bitch got $50,000. Where's my pistol, Brown? Where's my pistol? Because I need to shoot this nigga. Now, I'm not going to kill him. I'm going to shoot him in his ass to let him know Madea's mad as shit right now. Right. See, that's why I'm talking to my brother. So I appreciate you calling me. I do. I appreciate you calling us. But when you call me, what you going to do? Well, let me say this. Let me say this, and I want to talk again.
I'm gonna write you a check, Monique. Seriously, because hear me. Because this is the thing about this. And when we start talking about this, we're doing this, and this, we're doing that, and black people doing this, and black people doing that. What would we understand about that is this: where we are right now, and what we're trying to do, we got some opportunities that a lot of most people didn't have. So what I don't want you to feel one day, not one day, is that you were mistreated or that you were treated unfairly. Now, if that means that's what I need to do, then you do that. You do that. You take that and take it from a place of love.
Let me tell you where I'm going to take it from. Let me tell you where I'm going to take it from. I'm going to take it from its business, and I'm going to take it from my brother saying, listen, yo, this is what y'all was supposed to get.
Okay, so let's recap real quick. Now, Tyler tells her, I don't know what the movie has made, but I'm going to find out what it made, and I'm going to get it to you. All right? That's him trying to make it right. Trying to make sure you're paid for what you did, plus some. But it's still not what y'all want. You see what I'm saying? Like, so what is it that you want from him? And he said he's going to make it right. But see, the thing is, you arguing about two different things. That's what people don't understand. She's arguing about a statement Tyler made. Tyler made a statement about after the movie stuff. He didn't have nothing to do with the actual movie. It was after with the promotions. That's when she was like, I'm not doing the promotions because we're not getting paid and it wasn't under contract. So that's where he came in, was trying to talk to her to do the promotion because the movie is going to be big. It's going to be big and you're going to get, you do this and you're going to go on and be great. Which happens for that young girl that she was talking about, you paid her only $50,000. That young girl has been in movies ever since Precious. I am not lying. She's been in everything. So that's what he was trying to tell Monique. But Monique never had other things. That's her thing. She had other things. Now, Tyler trying to make it right. Like he said, I have nothing to do with the other stuff. That was Oprah. So you trying to make him come and apologize for that. Now, he did say she was a little difficult about that part. And that's what he said. On that end, yeah, I did have some issues with the promoting this stuff. But he didn't have nothing to do with the movies. So you see what I'm saying? So this is where we at. I hate that I took that long to get there, but the shit.
No, here's the thing, brother.
Well, I don't know what you're supposed to
do. Here's what we're saying is, when you say, I don't know what it's supposed to be, but I'm going to send you the check. Listen, not charity, brother. We don't, because see, what happens is, what's not going to take place on our watch is this. I wrote a check for something that came in, and it's one of those things where you're missing the point. And we believe enough in the universe to understand that, listen, when a person come to you sincerely with understanding what it is that you're talking about, versus just saying, I'm gonna find out what it is and I'm gonna write a check. Now it's in the tabloids, you wrote us a check. Because, you know, I know you flew Whitney Houston in on your private jet. You know, you gave TD Jakes $1 million. And the whole thing is the way that this is being done, it's like, don't throw us no chump change. Because we had to go through a movie audit with Lee for monies that he didn't get. And they're saying that he did something with the money from the movie. Okay. These are the things that we had to deal with. So to speak about the dollars that you're going
to. That's the thing that I have to deal with too, because I bought the movie to Lionsgate.
Listen to what I'm saying though. Listen, Tyler, this is what I need you to hear me. Hold on. In life, you can't walk around mad at everybody because one person did something to you. You must be able to compartmentalize where your frustrations lie.
Now, you making this statement, but you guys are mad at everybody. So you're not making sense what you're saying. And there's something, it's that little thing that you're doing. Every time Tyler tried to talk, you cut him off. Like over talking. And I know, ladies, that y'all don't know why men don't argue like you guys do, because we're going to fight. We're going to fight. We're not going to sit here and go back and forth and yeah, and screaming and yelling. We're going to fight. And what this dude is doing is kind of challenging Tyler. You know, he keep this over talk, wait, and stopping him and doing these long, slow-ass monologues, you know. And only so much a dude going to take from you, you know. But he is, you know, I don't know what he's doing, but I can see where what Tyler said, he didn't want to talk to him. He wanted to talk to Monique. He said he don't want to. They'll meet, but he don't want to meet with him. But I can see why, because it probably go down.
So when you say that you had the things going on with the movie, and then you had it with Lee and then Monique, you're lumping everyone together. And that's what people of color have a tendency of happening to them. They're all this way. See, if you just focus specifically on the interaction with Monique and yourself and I, it ain't never been anything but cordial, even in times of disagreement, because our thing is we not looking to it's like we said on the podcast, who in the hell wrote the story about how David stepped to Goliath and said, y'all are Goliaths. We just the Davids. We not in no position to be trying to start. We not looking to try to start any beef. But at the end of the day, all I'm asking you in your private time, because it's not going to happen right now on the phone, all I ask you in your private time is, how would you want to be treated if you were in a situation with people or a person put out something false about you? Then someone said that they didn't have the same experience with you. They're glad that they had a great experience with.
This is why I have trouble answering that question, because it starts as a question and it goes in that direction. So I was on to you for a minute.
Let me stay with the question, because you make a good point. Let me stay with the question. The question is, what would you want someone to do for you who said things about you and or mentioned things about you, alluding to the difficulties that they had with you, all because, I'm not finished, all because you chose,
I got an answer.
How can you answer something and I'm not finished?
Okay, well, let me answer part of the question and then you give me the other part. How about that?
Can you do me a favor? Can you, since you called up to have a real conversation, typically, I know you used the directing, but what I need you to do is just hear me out man to man. And that is this. How would you feel if someone says something about you that you were not contractually obligated to do? What would you want them to do to make that right. And it don't have nothing to do with money.
If somebody had said that, let me just try to be in the position. If somebody had come along and said, Tyler's difficult, he's terrible to work with, he's not going to do anything that you want him to do. He is, if they said all those things, right? If that's what the rumor was, and there were other people who knew that was not to be true, I would want those people to stand up and say, that's not true.
So, will you and Oprah do that?
I can't speak for Oprah.
Will you do that?
It's my experience. I've never worked with Monique. All I can speak for is my experience on pressure. I don't give a damn about saying that.
Would you do what you wanted done for you, Tyler? It's real simple. Would you do what you would want done for you? Because you told David, when he said his experience was wonderful, you said that was not your experience. And the question I would have, what did you experience with Monique and or I that made your interaction with us displeasurable? Especially.
I see exactly where you're going. What made my interaction displeasurable is to have to try to navigate between Precious, Lee, Monique not wanting to do any national press without getting paid, having to navigate through all of that. That's where my problem was.
But.
Boom. There it is. That's what I've been trying to get right there. He answered old slow talking ass dude question. Now he got an answer. What else you still want? He gave you an answer. He told you what it is that he had not so good interaction with her. And that was navigating with that, going out and doing the promotions and stuff. She probably said something to him. He didn't like what she said. And that's probably why. And she may not thought it was a terrible thing. And she may have did it in front of people. You know what I mean? A lot of stuff, just because we cool, that don't mean you can talk to me any kind of way in front of people. Do y'all understand how that work? She'll curse you out in a heartbeat. She'll say what's on her mind, all that shit. And that's all good in the hood. But when y'all working and people standing around and y'all got all this stuff going on, there's a chain of command. And when you sitting there telling the top chain this and this and this and this, they're going to look at you a little different. I'm just going to be honest with you. They may not say anything. They're just going to look at you like, oh, okay. That's where we at. Now, a minute ago, you said we like this, but you forgot you actually showed me what you really thought about me during that conversation. But now we back to brother and sister. You understand? So it's a lot of this flipping back and forth with this old slow-talking-ass husband of hers, and he is trying to keep it going. I don't know why, because it's ruining his wife's career. And she doesn't see that. She's so smutting with this dude, or what do you call it, smitten with this dude. She don't understand. He is ruining her career because she should have been back on track by now. He's the one sitting back with all this. I don't know who y'all think y'all saving. I really don't, because ain't nobody following y'all like that. So you're not out here saving the world. So all this shit y'all talking about, the community and all the people, all these, the babies and all that. Who are you talking about? Let's just be real, people. Let's just get off the train of who got money, who don't. Let's just get on to what are you really talking about? Because you've been saying the same crap for years. Get over it. They're not going to apologize. Not the way you want anyway. Move on. Get your life together. Move on. You ain't got to say nothing else to these dudes. Get your life and go.
But Tyler, this is where we are, though. I'm talking in real time. But when you understand, because you're, again, speaking about other entities and components besides Monique, what we're saying is what made it this play. But what I'm saying to you is I want your experience based upon your understanding that Monique, as we told you then, writing those scripts, or whoever wrote those scripts, they understand life.
Come on.
And I thought it was you. And if you don't understand that when you sit by and you say nothing, when you know it's wrong, as you now said, you know, and you agree, then what is the call really for, my brother?
What is it?
All right. I'm going to say this because I spent way too much time here. I thought that this would be a free call that I could just call and say how I felt and to absolutely wish you the best. The only way this changes, I think, for you guys and where you are is this. I think Monique needs an amazing movie. She needs to be with a great director. And once the movie's done, it comes out, she gets all this kind of buzz. She gets all this that she did before. And then this thing goes away. That's the way this changes. It's got to be the right thing that comes along. Kind of some of the stuff that Octavia Spencer has been doing that comes along, or Viola comes along. She does that. And all of this goes away. I know the town and how it works. It's like, okay, oh, that was a moment that's passed. She's amazing. That was wrong. So what you're asking me to do right now, first of all, I'm not going to get into this right now because it's ugly and it's nasty. And it came from a comedy skit. I don't want to be a part of
it. What is ugly and nasty, Tyler, about saying, because we're not talking about the comedy skit. You're obviously not hearing what I'm saying. Here's the thing.
You said you don't want any chump change. Does that mean you do not want the money for Precious or what?
Wait a minute, brother. Hold up. Because see, now what happens is the billionaire's starting to come out.
Right.
Now what's happening is when you call and say, I didn't mean for this to take this long, brother, you called us. And see, what that said was when we first got the call, I'm going to tell you some real stuff. My heart skipped a beat because I said, okay, we get ready to talk to a real cat because he reached out. But now the tone you're beginning to take is, I'm a billionaire, and I ain't got time for this, and it ain't going the way I thought it should. Wait, hold up, brother. Hold up, because see, you'll start over talking. I ain't got time for this, and let me say this. And when you say chump change, here's the thing, baby. See, the community is involved right now. You know it, and I know it, and everybody out there know it. The community is involved, and they want to see how it's going to play out, because the community is saying, wait a minute, y'all. Hold up. We don't know this sister to be no bullshitter. We know she a loud mouth. We know she'll say some shit off the wall. But what we know about her is she true to her word.
And all I would ask you is two questions. The first question is, did you not just say it was wrong?
Tyler.
Did you not just say it was wrong, Tyler? To say she was difficult for not doing something that she was not contractually obligated to do? Did you not say that you would feel that was wrong? Or am I missing something?
I absolutely said that, yes.
So the question I would say is... So the question I would say is... But
I didn't mean to spend this much time on it because just like you were there with your beautiful twins, I got a little boy. And I want to make sure when I'm off, that's where my attention is.
Here's the thing. You shouldn't have made the call until you were able to talk. But the last question I would ask you, hold up. The last thing I want to ask you is this. It's real simple. If you said it was wrong, when do you speak up and say that it was wrong, Tyler? That's it.
Okay, then that means telling my whole experience, which about how I feel about the whole thing. That means telling my whole experience.
Whatever you listen, Tyler.
Without explaining the whole situation.
Tyler, here's the thing. You are articulate. You is smart.
Okay. And you is kind.
And you is kind.
Okay.
Listen to me. This ain't the billionaire. This is me. Cut all that out. This is me talking to y'all.
Then please talk to us, brother.
Talk to us real, because all I'm saying to you is that...
Listen to me. I told you how I think that this changes.
Okay, see, there was a lot in that little bit right there. And I also noticed the old slow-talking dude was trying to cut him off when he was about to tell something. Because he said, Tyler admitted, yeah, there was something said. Now, dude comes back and say what he says. So are you willing to get out and say it basically to the world? And he said, okay, so you want me to say it and why I felt that way. Because, see, there's some more behind it. So, and then dudes start like, but, cutting him off. But see, this the whole thing. There's something behind why he said what he said. And so, if you want me to apologize, I'm going to tell you why I apologize, and I'm going to tell it all. Now, could that make it worse? Probably so. Would he be vindicated? Yes. But is that going to help Monique get roles? Hell no. And the dude, and I'm telling you, man, all this, you the billionaire talking, you the, he's a fucking billionaire. I don't care what y'all say, y'all could trip or whatever you want. You become billionaire status, you are not letting people talk to you any kind of way. Let's just be real. All this keeping it real shit that we out here saying in the hood and all that, that don't mean shit nowhere else. Nowhere. All my friends that kept it real, all my homeboys kept it real, all my cousins that kept it real, didn't go nowhere because they were too busy keeping it real. Didn't go nowhere. They went to jail. They still living at home with their grandmothers. They don't have cars. They're old as dirt, still not working. But I guarantee you, they'll keep it real on your ass. And see, and she tries to cut herself out when she's saying, well, everybody know I can got the mouth, I can do this and say this and say this. People, that does not give you an out. You are talking business. You talking to executives, just like you was at a job. You're not sitting next to in a cubicle talking shit. Then that the CEO of the company comes in. Everybody ass tighten up. Start doing the work right. He speaks and goes through. Then he gets to you and you's like, you ain't doing none of that. Well, how are you? How are you doing? I'm keeping it real. I don't bow down to nobody. Say that shit and see if you have your job tomorrow. Let's just be real. And all I'm trying to say is there's a lot where people jump on stuff and expect us to just like, we get to fall in line with the worst part of our culture. Let's put it like that. We talk about going to school. We talk about being business owners, all this other stuff. But we harp on keeping it ghetto as crap as much as possible. And I do not understand that. We will argue to death that somebody, what, you talking white because he talk proper, speak proper English? We have a problem with it. If I don't wear the same shoes you wear, we have a problem with it. I can't drive the car you think I'm supposed to have. You have a problem with it. But that's keeping it real in the hood. People wearing stuff they can't afford and living in Section 8 or at home with your mothers and grandmothers. This makes no sense, people. The community is watching. What community? You see what I'm saying? Who is watching this and saying, what? Get over it and move on. Everybody in their life have people that has double-crossed them, said stuff about them, and you got to say, you know what? F them. I'm moving on with my life. And most of the time when you do that, you end up doing what you need to do and it's prosper afterwards. But the reason her shit can't kick off is because she keep going back and demanding people need to apologize or say something to her the way she want them to say it. And I had to tell somebody this a while back, it's like, you can't expect people to apologize to you the way you feel like they should. If they apologize, they apologize. And you got to take it, like you say, receive it, and let it go. And if you don't want to do that, then just don't get involved with them trying to apologize to you. Just simple as that. So this is stupid. The whole call is stupid. Why she put it out there is stupid. Because it ain't no good look for her and her husband. It make it look like they're difficult, extremely difficult. Well, guys, that's it for me on this. I mean, it was a lot. I was trying to get in between, but I know some people don't like me to talk in between, but I needed to point some things out, what's going on, because everybody just kind of leading with a brush or a little brief summary of what they think it is. So it's a lot of stuff hidden within that one message that they didn't understand. You got it? All right, so you guys let me know what you think about it. Comment. Let me know. Let's talk about it, all right? And as always and always, it is your boy, Mr. Nobody. And I'm up out of here. Hey, y'all keep it real. Your boy, I'm out of here. Peace.